Glory to God. Happy New Year, everyone. You're welcome to our year of unlimited grace. Glory to God. And I know the Lord has brought you this far for a purpose. Hallelujah. You know, have you ever asked yourself, how could I ever have a great year? Yes, I'm here to show you just that this morning. I'm Pastor Peter Shazobo, bringing God's word to you. So I'll be sharing from the book of Romans chapter 5 verse 17. And it reads, it said, much more those of us who've received abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness shall reign as kings in life. Of course, I'm taking the B part. It's a much more those of us who've received abundance of grace. You know, we've come into a season where the grace of God will be so much manifest for as many who can trust Him and as many who will tap into His divine grace and favor by the Spirit. You know, the past year, 2020, saw so many challenges coming our way, but then the scripture lets us know that as many who put their trust in Him will never be put to shame. And that's a season that the Lord has brought us into. It's a season that if only we can trust Him, if only we can hold on to His word, if only we can act on the word, we will walk on waters. Hallelujah. So relax. It's a time that we can tap into the unusual, the unfathomable, the limitless grace of God. Grace means unmerited favor. It is that which you didn't work for. It is that which you don't deserve. You know, grace has nothing to do with your abilities. It has nothing to do with your educational, attainment. It has nothing to do with your ancestry. It has nothing to do with your special skills, but it has everything to do with your connection with God. It has everything to do with your connection with the divine will and purposes of God for your life and for mankind. So if only you can align yourself in this new season, because a new season that we've just come into, if only you can align yourself, like the Lord spoke to us yesterday, unusual things will begin to happen, and that is in the positive. This is a year where you'll be called up for opportunities that maybe you don't deserve, that maybe you originally may not even be the best for it, but because grace chose you, because grace separated you, because grace set you up for this occasion, you see things happening for you that ordinarily others would ask, how come? How was this possible? But the grace of God, that beautifier, the grace of God, the lifter, the grace of God, the promoter, the grace of God that, you know, make way where there seems to be no way, that grace will work for you in this new season. You know, I'm not going to tell you that there may not be challenges. There will be a lot of challenges in 2021. There will be a lot of issues in 2021. But listen, we that are God's people, we've been adequately fortified. We've been adequately prepared. Just like Joseph was prepared for the occasion. Yes, he had to go through some trials though. He had to go through some circumstance though. He had to go through prison though. He had to be a victim or be lied against. But you know what? He was adequately prepared for the occasion, for that occasion when the king Pharaoh had to call him forth, and Joseph at that moment became the most sought after man in the whole of Egypt. And Pharaoh asked, he said, where will we find a man like you on who there is the wisdom of the gods? Hallelujah. You see, men in this season that you've come into, we begin to take note of the qualities and grace that God has deposited in you. They'll find out that the solution that they've ever dreamt of, that they've been seeking after, that they've been looking out for, that those solutions are resident in you. So they'll seek after you. Hallelujah. Why? Because the Lord has taken you through a season where He prepared you. Hallelujah. And that's what we've done in the last few days. We've sought after the Lord. We've prayed. We've spoken words of power. We've declared words of prophecy over our lives and over our future in 2021 and beyond. And you know what? This is the season. We've just stepped into it and we'll begin to walk in prophecies. We begin to walk in the word. Yes, we begin to walk in the word, just like Jesus walked on waters. And then Peter said, "If it be you, ask me to come." And Jesus gave the word. He said for Peter to come. And Peter stepped on the waters. Yes, you know, it was not just the mere waters that Peter was stepping on. But remember, he acted based on the word of God. So in other words, he was stepping on the words of Jesus. And you know what? The Bible said, and he walked on waters until he doubted the word. Because he saw the wave, because he saw the situation, he doubted. Then he began to seek. That lets you know, if only we trust God, if only we hold on to his word, we'll walk on waters this season. Hallelujah. There is nothing that we can't do this season. Yeah, there is no limitations before us that can stand successfully. All such limitations will fall down flat. Yeah, because it's a season of unlimited grace. So you hold on to the word of God, you walk on the word. Yes, you act on the word. You use the word as your sure armor of defense. Yes, you act on the word because the word says so. You believe it and that settles it. And you're going to see uncommon testimonies. Yeah, in your family, in your job, in your business, in your academics. Yeah, you're going to see ways being made open. Yes, you're going to see what has been splitted before you. You're going to see the rock gushing out waters for you. Yes, with joy. This is a season. Another thing the Lord told me, he said, this is a season where we experience joy. Yes, joy. Not because there will not be challenges, but joy, because joy comes from our spirit. Joy is a function of the recreated human spirit. It stems up from there. Yes, so that your joy does not depend on the circumstance around you. It does not depend on the economy. It does not depend on your job. It does not depend on, you know, the health situation around. But then the joy from your spirit stems out, and as you flow in that realm of joy, the Bible says rejoice always. Again, I say rejoice. As you operate in that realm of rejoicing always, and you know what? No matter the tide, no matter the wave, no matter the storm, no matter the challenges that will come, you see yourself surmounting and overcoming all those situations that the enemy may throw your way with joy. The Bible said, with joy you shall draw waters. With joy, you draw waters from the wells of salvation. Yes, that's the season we've just entered. A season where we begin to draw with joy. Waters from the wells of salvation. Miracle waters from the wells of salvation. So it's your season. It's time to celebrate the Lord. And it's a season that you need to, you know, set goals, set your priorities right. Jesus says, seek first the kingdom in Matthew 6:33. He says, seek ye first the kingdom and his righteousness. And he said, and all these things, what are all those things? The house that you have desired for, the car that you desired for, yes, the family that you desire, yes, the husband, the wife, the, you know, the children that you've always desired for, these things will come naturally. They'll be added. There'll be an addition. Don't let those be your focus. Don't let the house be your focus. Don't let the car be your focus. Let Jesus be your focus in 2021. Yes, this is the way to having a great year. This is how to have a great year and a great day. Let Jesus be your focus. Let the kingdom of God be your focus. And you know what? Every other thing Jesus said. He said every other thing. Yes, the house, the car, the children, all these things will be added. Yes, you know, as believers, all these things are additions to us. But our focus is the kingdom. Our focus is Jesus. Yes, our focus is this kingdom that we've received in our heart. And this word gives us joy, bubbling joy within that is unspeakable, but I'm full of glory. Hallelujah. So this season you've just entered will be a season where the glories of God will arise in your life. The scripture declares, arise and shine, for your light has come, and the glory, the glory will be seen in your life this season. Hallelujah. For many who have thought that yours was finished, that you were done for, they will see a resurgence. Hallelujah. A resurgence of God's glory in your life, in your academics, in your finances, in your marriage. A resurgence of hope, a resurgence of life, a resurgence of beauty. Yes, the beauty of God will be seen and celebrated in everything that pertains to you. This is your season. You know, get set, because great things are coming to be. Yeah, in the midst of the challenges that will come also, but you know what? If you will react with the word of God, if you will speak the word of God into situations that will come your way, you speak the word of God into circumstances that will come your way, because sure, the devil will come, his agents will come, the enemies will come trying to stop you, but you know what? You hold on to the word of God this season as you speak the word of God against situations, as you speak the word of God against circumstances, as you speak the word of God against challenges, you will come back with the testimony. Hallelujah. Listen, the grace of God has been bestowed on you as a child of God. He said much more those of us who've received the abundance of grace, like we've just seen in Romans 5:17. Much more those of us. Listen, we are those who have been set apart. We are a different class of men. A class of men that have been set for this season. It's our season. He said much more those of us who've received. We've received this grace. We didn't get it ourselves. It's not our own, but we've received it. It's a free gift from God. But now it is in our life and it's domiciled in us. So you know what? The fruit is being seen. It's a much more those of us who've received the burdens of grace and the gift of righteousness. We shall reign in life. We shall reign in life by one Jesus Christ. Listen, this time for you to reign as a child of God, it's not time to be a victim anymore. It's not time to be down. It's not time to be under. It's not time to be a victim. A few days ago, as we were during the prayer sections and through the fasting, the Lord spoke to me and he said to me that you declare, that I tell the people to declare that I'm a victor. And I told God's people, we are victors. And we need to let that sink into our consciousness. Let it be your reality. You speak to yourself all of the time. It doesn't matter the situation you find yourself. You say, I'm a victor against this sickness. I'm a victor in the face of this joblessness. I'm a victor in the face of poverty. I'm a victor in the face of this pandemic. I'm a victor. Proclaim your victory. That's the way to have in a great year. That's a way to unleash the power that has been given to you in this unlimited grace that the Lord has spoken to us about. Listen, it's time to step out by faith. It's time to step out with the power of God's word that's at work in us. Yes, for much more those of us who've received, we've received abundance of grace. You have to be conscious about it. If you're not conscious about it, you cannot eat the fruit thereof. If you're not conscious about it, you cannot take possession of that which has been given to you. Yes, be conscious that you've received. It's a much more those of us who've received. We've received. You declare. You say, I have received abundance of grace. I'm not ordinary. I belong to a new class of men. That class of men that have been set apart by the Lord Jesus to display his glory. We are that class of men in which the world will see the glory. For scripture says, arise and shine, for the light has come. My light has come. My light has come in 2021 and beyond. My light has come. And the glory of God is being seen in my health, in my finances, in my job, in my family. My light has come because unlimited grace has been made upon me, has been given to me, has been bestowed on me. My light has come. Glory to God. And somebody say, oh, pastor, I really like what you're talking about. I just wish it is true. What do you mean if it is true? It is true. This is the reality we live in. He said, but I don't know about it because I'm not a Christian. No, listen, you could become one now. It's never too late. There could be no better time to start off with the Lord than to start up with Him in a new year. You could become a child of God here and now. The scripture tells us, it says, if thou shalt confess with your mouth and believe in the heart that God raised Christ from the dead, He said, you shall be saved. The scripture also said, He said, whosoever, and you fall in that category, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. You can declare that today. You can call upon the name of the Lord and you'll be a child of God. And all these good words, that this message that the Lord has for us will be yours. So just repeat this prayer after me, meaning it from the depth of your heart. You say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I've heard your word. I come to you. I believe that you sent your son Jesus Christ as a perfect sacrifice for my sin. And that he came, that he died, was buried, and on the third day, he rose again for my justification. Today, I declare, according to scriptures, that I'm born again. If you have just made that prayer from the depth of your heart, you're born again. Welcome to the family of God. Look out for a Bible-believing church in the city where you live. You know, join that church and let you be groomed up and trained in the things of God. But if you live anywhere around Padova in Italy, anywhere, maybe in any of the adjoining cities like Mestre, Venice, Vicenza, Rovigo, Ferrara, Bologna, even Treviso, I want to invite you specially this coming Sunday, which is on the 3rd of January. This coming Sunday, which is the first, actually the 3rd of January, we're going to have our first Sunday service. Glory to God. Glory to God. The very first Sunday service for the year. And it's going to be awesome. 2021, you don't have to miss the very first Sunday service. So I want to invite you to come worship with us at Healing Grace Christian Assembly via J Avanzo number 17, just behind the Padova train station. The time for the Sunday school is 10 o'clock and the main service will start by 11 o'clock. And we will be celebrating God. And you know what? I'll be praying for the sick. We'll be blessing God's people for the new year, releasing words of power and prophecies over your 2021. So ensure to be with us for this special service. And you know, tell your friends, ensure to share this message at least to 10 persons. Do the work of an evangelist. Let everyone be around on Sunday and we will be having a great time. The Lord will be releasing graces, unlimited grace on you for the new year. And you don't want to miss that. God bless you. I want to wish you have a great year and have a year of unlimited grace. God bless you. Bye.